this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create pretty realistic liquid bubbles, all with standard effects. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. First of all, we need to create the basic shape of the bubble. Therefore, we choose the ellipse tool and double-click on it. Are you using the latest version of After Effects? A new window popped up. The property window. This is amazing. Instead of opening all the properties down in the timeline, you can now directly access them here. So first of all, let's adjust the size of the shape. We uncheck constraint proportions and set the size to 350 by 350 pixels for now. I guess I add it to the effects controls window. Here. Where did you place it in your work area? Let me know in the comments. Let's name the layer Bubble 1. No stroke, fill color white. Next, let's distort this perfectly round shape a little. We use the effects and presets window to search for the turbulent displace effect. Select it and add it. Let's adjust some of the settings. We set the amount to around 20, the size to around 90. Then we animate the evolution with a time expression. We add an expression to the property and add time asterisk 50, which increases the evolution value by 50 degrees per second. A continuous linear animation in just a few seconds. Expressions allow you to create complex animations that wouldn't be possible otherwise. In my new course, we start from zero, from basic expressions to responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. You'll have a whole set of new tools which will make you faster, better, and stand out from the crowd. And I'll add new bonus lessons each month. Reasons enough to check out the course. Link is in the description. Alright, let's duplicate the bubble and reduce the size to 200 by 200 pixels. We position it very close to the first bubble. Then we add an adjustment layer to add some liquid attributes to the shapes. Let's name it Liquid. First of all, we add a Gaussian blur effect to the adjustment layer. We use the effects and presets window again, set the blurriness to 40, and uncheck repeat edge pixels. Then we add a matte joker effect. Set geometric softness 1 to around 75. Choke 1 to minus 15, gray level softness to 2%. Now the shapes behave like liquid drops. This anchor point is messed up though. Let's use the anchor point tool to move it back to the center of the shape. Hold Command if you use a Mac or Control to let it snap. Awesome. Now we need to work on the style. Therefore, we use layer styles. Let's choose the large bubble and right click on it. We select layer styles and choose inner shadow first of all. We open the property and set the blend mode to normal. The color to white. I think we need to change the fill color of the shape to actually see what we're doing. Let's choose black. We better change it for the second shape as well. Then let's get back to the layer style. You set the distance to 7. The size to around 80. Next, we choose bevel and emboss. Open the property and set the style to pillow emboss. The size to 30. You set the highlight mode to normal. Choose pink as the highlight color. You set the shadow mode to normal as well. And choose neon green as color. We add one more layer style. Close some properties here. Right click on the layer again, layer styles, and choose stroke. Let's open the property The blend mode is normal already. We choose blue as color this time. It slowly starts to look like a bubble, I think. Let's increase the size to around 10 though. Awesome. We select the layer style property and copy it. Then we paste it to the second bubble. You probably need to reduce some of the layer style values for smaller bubbles. Awesome, real bubbly. Next, we take the pre-bubbles comp and add it to a new comp. Let's name this one Main Bubbles. We need to add a background object that refracts to make it look more convincing. First of all, let's add a new solid, which we name Background. We move it to the bottom of the layer stacking order and add a gradient ramp. Let's use the effects and presets window again, double click to add it. We change the colors. Let's start with a very dark purple. And end with a brighter purple. We adjust the start and end of ramp. Let's give it a diagonal direction. Finally, let's add some ramp scatter to avoid color bending. Then let's add some content. That could either be a comp or let's add a text layer. We grab the type tool and add some text. Bubbles, all capitals. I use BioSans Bold. The font is available on Adobe Fonts, if you want to use it as well. We align the text layer to the center using the Align tool. Then we duplicate the text layer and the bubbles comp. Hide the top bubbles comp for now. We use the bottom bubbles comp as alpha track mat for both text layers. Invert the track mat for the bottom text layer. We've split the text up into two parts, outside the bubbles and inside the bubbles. We need the separation to distort the type inside the bubble. We select the top text layer and add an effect, CC glass. Double click on it to add it. Let's adjust some settings. We select one of the pre-bubbles comps as bump map and set property to alpha, softness to 75, height to 100, and displacement to 160. In shading, let's reduce diffuse to around 20, specular 100. Finally, we make the top pre-bubbles comp visible again and set its blending mode to screen. Awesome. All you need to do now is go back into the pre-bubbles comp and animate the positions of the bubbles. Let me know in the comments what you think about the new properties window. If you want to learn more about expressions, check out my course. Link is in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.